This presentation contains reinforcement details on beams, slabs, meter rebars, columns, footings, and steel bolted connections. First, reinforcement detail of steel. Steel is provided for taking tensile reinforcement in the slabs, generally in concrete works, and the support tensile force is available at the bottom, and the minimum tensile force is in bottom. So, the reinforcement is meant like this. This is at the support, tensile reinforcement is provided under the law. And then L4 to L5 distance is again went up and bottom. This is main reinforcement. Alternative rods of these are provided, and this is the extra generally called as extra reinforcement, but these reinforcements are necessary to maintain this spacing. These are distributary reinforcements. Distributary reinforcements are generally provided in the diameter of 6 mm or 8 mm for smaller spans. At the middle portion, these distributory reinforcements are provided at the top of the main reinforcement. At the support area, the main rods are available at the top. Distributory rods are provided at the bottom of the main reinforcement. This is a cover block for to maintain the proper covering of slab. This is called as chair. This chair is provided for maintaining the proper position of the top reinforcement in a slab. This is a two-way slab. Consider this is x-axis and y-axis. This on both directions, top reinforcements and the bottom reinforcements are provided. This is called two-way slab. One-way slab and two-way slabs are based on the length to breadth ratio, that means L by Y L X ratio. This ratio is greater than 2, it is called as 1-way slab. If it is less than 2, it is called as 2-way slab. The design is based on this ratio. This is 1-way slab. This is the beam. This beam acts as a support. This is top reinforcement. This is bottom reinforcement. These are distributory rods. This is the fabrication work of steel reinforcement. These are the electrical pipes provided for power points in a building for fans, lights, and additional works. Next, concrete. This is the concrete time of a slab. Here the thickness is properly maintained by using a chair. This is the top reinforcement, this is the bottom reinforcement. This is the beam. A vibrator is used for augmenting the concrete inside the beam. This is called a linear vibrator. Generally this vibrator is used at the time of concreting in beams and columns. This is the pipeline work, that means the electricity work. Next, this is the reinforcement detail of the column. The bottom, these rods are footing reinforcements. This is the column. The vertical reinforcements are called as main rods. These main rods are bent up some distance above the bottom reinforcement of the footing. This is also another example of the column reinforcement. Here also the main rods are bent like this. This is a circular column. This is a rectangular column. Next, this is a beam. Generally, top rod of the beams are bent down like this. This is to provide a proper stability to the tensile reinforcement at the top of the beam. Here, these are the shear reinforcements. These are the legs. This is the true length shear reinforcement. These legs are alternatively provided to avoid splitting up, remove any vibration or additional loads. Here also, this clears the alternate direction of the shear reinforcement legs. This is the fabrication of the beam. This is also direction of the beam. These are the corner rods. These corner rods are necessary to provide to our movement of the beam rods. This provides some stability to the beams at the time of the earthquake or any vibrations in the beam. These are the different types of legs. This is a single leg stirrup. This is two leg stirrups. That is also two leg. This is four leg stirrups. That is six leg stirrups. This is a common reinforcement. This is the fabrication of the extension of the column. This is the 3D diagram of the structure: column, footing, beams. Next, the retaining box. This is a typical cantilever retaining box. This portion is a cantilever portion. This is above the ground level. This is the back side. This is the back fill, that is earth fill area. This is keel stub. This is post stub area. Generally here, providing a key, that is called as a key, to avoid the movement or sliding whenever the available force is high. This is the stem reinforcement, that means cantilever reinforcement of the retaining bar. Alternative rods are cut at some distance based on the design. This is called as curtailment of the rod. This is to avoid excess reinforcement in the structure, and also it provides some economical benefit. This is a reinforcement of water tank. Here also alternative rods are cutted. This is called as curtailment of the rods. Next is steel bolted connection. This is the prefabricated steel structures. This is the one of the joint in an I section. This is the I section. This I section is not readily available. This is a manufactured I section, fabricated I section, using a plates for member flange portions are created by using welding. This is connected by plates carrying some bolts. This is one type of design. This is the pin to pin connection with this. This is a column, this is a beam. This column, steel beam, and steel columns are connected together with L-angles using bolts. This is one direction, this is another side of the column and the beam connection. This is also another type of connection. Here, this is also column and beam connection. Here, L-angles are not used. Plates are welded with the I-sets of the beam and the bolts are created and it is directly connected with the column. This is also another connection. This is the 3D diagram of the diagram from the software. This also clarifies the connection details of the beam and the column. This is the compression of this